Thank you. The next speaker is Professor Manoj Kumar Jha.
Thank you, Honorable Deputy Chairman, sir. I am here to express some of very serious concerns on behalf of my party about this proposed bill. Some of those very serious concerns, of all the judgments which my colleague, my friend, senior friend, my colleague Abhishek ji listed, I will not repeat them. But in view of 26th September 2018 judgment, I think whatever the Honorable Minister Sahib said in the initial remarks, or whatever we read here, I wish to draw in Emilia from Othello. You told a lie, an odious damned lie, upon my soul a lie, a wicked lie. It's from Othello, Emilia, in a particular context. So what worries me as a member of this house, somewhere I'll speak about a couple of general concerns which I wish to express to through you to Honorable Minister Sir. Are we on a trajectory to develop a web camera state 24/7? A state which the biggest hallmark of the state is surveillance? I think so. This is going to create lots of anomalies. I repeat it, that the Supreme Court's observation was exclusively on the issues which had subsidy tenor. What we have done, we have taken away initially what we thought of making it. So I'll take a couple of issues, point by point. Section 4, Honorable Minister Sir, you talk about offline verification, the bill talks about, and then it is enforcement mechanism. There is no clarity. What is the enforcement mechanism to be developed? Because as many of my colleagues said, that at several point in this proposed bill, there is to be decided by the executive, to be decided later. I don't think that this is a very good legislative practice, or this is a very good practice whereby the parliament is not aware what is going to happen subsequently, sir. So I believe that not only would I should provide a list of alternatives to biometric information. Now, when you say informed consent, we are living through a very difficult time. We have also seen under the cover of informed consent, we have obtained coercive consent. I see lots of ideas of coercive consent in this, sir. And before I become member of the house, even after, I have been receiving calls from n number of companies asking for my Aadhaar details, sir. Section 33, and I particularly love some of the phrases used by this government consistently. It says Aadhaar ecosystem. Now, the phrase used, any entity in the Aadhaar ecosystem is overboard. I believe so. It should be defined. It should be specified. Otherwise, it shall be, and it should be basically applicable to entities, non-legal persons. This is my second. And third, sir, I believe that interestingly, in NRC, in one family, if four members have necessary documents and the fifth one doesn't have, we are excluding them. And through this bill, we don't wish to exclude anyone. Bring everybody by hook or by crook. And finally, sir, as an extension of my, what the kind of prerogative which a child gets at the age of attaining 18, within 6 months after attaining 18, I think that right should be available to all adults. And finally, sir, the very idea of one nation, one card kind of thing, it sounds good. It sounds wonderful. But the fact is, sir, I quote Mahmood Darwish. There's a poem called Identity Card. And he says it very loudly, sir. We might sing it after a few years. I'm an Arab. My identity card number is 50,000. That kind of scenario should not come, sir. These were some of my concerns. And even
Thank
if you,
you.
Have
Please
a legislative
conclude.
Majority,
Thank you.
I think I repeat that argument. Legislative majority should be in sync with moral majority. Thank you so much, sir.